Lovely, lovely place. I'm trying to catch that milk truck farther up, though. They do deliveries every morning. We'll have to check into that.
They drive very fast here.
Boy, they sure do. And you notice there's no place to park either. So every time you walk right next to the road. Lovely.
There's no speed limit signs.
Lovely brass, no, copper lanterns. Really nice hotel. This is the main entrance. Big parking area right here. And we are staying right around the corner over there. We're crazy, taking a picture of a rose bush. But the flowers here are phenomenally beautiful. Things you never see at home because they just don't survive in this weather. What a sight. Go in and meet Susan. Good morning, Maureen. Good morning. Let's go meet Susan. Thanks, Mo. This is the main lobby. Poor Susan thinks we're nuts. And they have fresh flowers all the time. Those are the stairs to the rooms. The lovely dining room. The pub is coming up to our right here. I'll go in and we'll just take a peek. They don't know us yet. Lovely soft furniture. Look at the lovely ladies at the bar. I know, no warning. You didn't know this was happening. It's hard to adjust.
That's enough, Mom. Quite enough.
Okay.
So
you gotta tell them this is the milkman.
Well, it says I carry extra milk, eggs, bread, cream, yogurt, and potatoes.
And guess what we just located?
Found Windsor Castle. We've got a guy over here. He's picking up some restaurants. Look at the immenseness of this place. Amazing.
He's smiling for you.
Yeah. Looks like a sweetheart. He knows he's on.
Good guys.
Oh, Maureen wants guys. Okay, we'll check that out. This is the giant archway we've just come through. And I think we're going to tour this. I can't believe the immensity of it. Absolutely. Look at those chimneys. The outer wall that we could see from the other side. Let's see a close-up. I can see the coat of arms. And let's go up and see the gargoyles. I don't know if the bad light's going to help or not.
Every coat of arms is different.
George's Chapel. Oh, Maureen. Okay. Look at the stonework. Lovely gardens. This is down in the moat, just below the top part of this castle here. And I'm going to try to get steps of what, honey? Look at this place.
Then there's a garden over there. There's a garden for us.
Smell, Mo. Pretty?
I like those stairs, though.
Okay, Maureen says there's stairs. Look at that. Grassy stairs.
it isn't framed. It's just cut out of the earth.
Down into for the Dowell collection. And we hear all this activity going on down here. Let's see if my camera can pick it up. All the school kids playing. Isn't that just fun?
No, down here. See if you can see that.
Hang on, Mo.
First part of the dollhouse, we've just come through the door.
Look at the palm trees on top of the bed.
And then it just goes up for more rooms. Look at the what, Maureen?
Palm trees on top of the bed.
Palm trees on top of the bed.
On the top? Puffy?
Okay, I've got it. Interesting.
Okay, go.
I just want to get down and get the cars. Other side of the dollhouse. Enormous, and it just goes up and up. And from that part to the side of the house, the mirror of the gardens. Gardens up on this side now. Maureen, can you tell what some of these rooms are?
They tell you what they are.
I'm glad they're telling you. What are they telling you?
You guys like to do dinner there.
Good.
Let's see if I can just pan in on that just a little bit more. Wow. Hey, folks. Look at those chairs, huh? Lord.
Look at that. I wouldn't have dusted either. Down and we'll see the crown jewels. Let's see. Peeing on that. So we're going around to the fourth side. And we'll get to see what kind of one it is. You can see the people coming in the door. This is a Queen's bedroom. Green, what's that? What's this bottom floor here? The kitchen?
Yeah.
And then down below is the storeroom.
Wine cellar.
Wine cellar. Ooh, that one's hard to see. I don't know. And yeah, one section of toys. Outside now. We've just come out of the dollhouse collection and it's really lovely.
Yeah.
But we've come over to the edge of the rampart and Mo is just kind of holding on for dear life because it just kind of really goes down.
We've even got pet midges here.
It is really lovely. They're like the gargoyles, and what happens when it rains, the rain comes out of their mouths and down the spout. Wouldn't that be fun? Come during a rainstorm. We've been checking gardens. We debated on if this guy was real. And he is. He moves back and forth. He's definitely a real guard.
He just stands there.
Bless his heart. Okay, this is the garden.
Now look at this wall of flowers.
Hang on, I'm coming. Where's the wall, Mo?
Right here.
She wants me to see this here.
No, come over here.
Okay, come over here, she says. Wow. She's leading me by the hand, if you could believe this. Man, oh man, oh man.
Yes,
actually.
Not this, this is it.
Look at the ducks going up the hill. They're eating as they go. Isn't this a riot? This is the old moat. We took this picture at the beginning of the garden down below.
It's a pretty enriched flag with the brown,
pan back a little bit so you can kind of see it again.
Now where that is up, or if you see a car going by,
there's the ducks eating as they go up the hill.
And
we're around the corner so we could see some of the
restoration.
The restoration going on.
Look at the green.
Where, Mo? Green-breasted bird, and he's going into the shrubs, Mo. Oh, I see some more movement. Let's see how close I can get. down here. See? What's the one on the wall? I can't tell the color from here, honey.
Nice. So she's also checking out the building. Looking at this beautiful wood. Short. Let me see. We're coming into Winchester now. You can hear all the traffic, and there's a lovely garden. Let's see if we can just kind of get a close-up here of what's what. People sitting down, rowing the umbrella. A lot of traffic. Oh, you're fine. Lots and lots of traffic. It's like William the Conqueror. Well, we found Winchester Cathedral. Our roof repair. Okay, there's the top. That's what all we can see right now. Working our way over. And wow. Renovations. And then it goes on through there. Don't think we can leave it. What does it say? But I spotted the roses out of the corner of my eye.
We're actually laying out some
right up to the stained glass. stairs to see that big archer. We just saw a few minutes ago, but I'm really intrigued by the woodwork in it. It is absolutely so intricate. Look at this. Just awesome. We're going to go back up to this side again, so if we can make it a little farther. So much to see. It won't do that because there's still a whole lot to see. Here's another whole room off to the side. I can't back it up anymore. Let's see if I can't get back into the corner here. We've got somebody else's crib. And then we have a bunch of people playing. Finally, go check it out. But look at this. Absolutely amazing. It's buried all over the place up here. This is absolutely amazing. Of this place. I won't be able to get everything in here. We've got old benches all over the place and signs for those chests. The ones up on the top. Now we're going to go inside and see that big altar. And it has those chests on the top. And it is so enormous. I kind of want you to get an overall view of kind of what's happening before I enter into through this door. Because it is so enormous.
In fact, the bigger ones down in the choir there, I'll give you a history of it bigger in pictures.
Just beautiful. Look at this. Look at all these things. I can't get detail in through here. Back down there is the back part of the altar that we saw when we first came in. I think you can probably almost see the arrangements they use, mostly garden flowers. They are huge. Oh gosh, that one was in itself be probably 3 feet. Desks. Some up there. Circle. Heading back towards the entrance, I've just made a big circle and coming down from the main crowd again. Heading back towards the main side. I'm going to turn this off and go back to the entrance. I don't want to walk over the altar area. I think make it around to the outside edge. Got talking to the guy and he says local women make those arrangements. And they have their pick from everybody's garden. This is the back side of what we had seen here. Okay, I'm on the complete opposite side now. Just going to check this out here. Chapel and two. Not so hard here. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, so hard. Oh, but we're gonna come around here. This one in itself is awesome. Could you imagine having this whole area for your own body? Found Bill and Maureen again. What's this one up, honey? And that's another bishop. Did what?
Did you?
That we were just in, and we had just seen him. I guess there's some more bones up in there, too, with one of these bishops here. Which bishop? Painted one was. Let me go see where the rest of the crew is here. Which one's that, Maureen? Huh?
No, it's a guy because he has a beard.
He doesn't say there's no tag or anything?
No, there's no tag on any
of that one. Look at these tiles. Absolutely amazing. Something. They've got it roped off so you can't walk on them. They really are something else. And this is through looking through one of the tombs. I'm heading down the back side. I've gone so much in and out around here. I kind of want to look up here and kind of pin in. Notice something really unique. They look like vultures. is so intricate. Standby ones up, they can hear the bells. This woodwork here. One of those before was grapes, but now they're really. They could do a trick. I see these shields up on the ceiling. Let's check them out. These guys. Jesse. No. Can't believe. I'm doing a high wire right here. And it goes way back over my head. Okay. Here's the ceiling again. Way back. Come down towards the very front entrance of the church again. Maybe that is before. Look at the tapestry on all these chairs. Okay, it's all needlework. And look at the tiny, tiny stitches, folks. It's telling me there's history in all the tapestry seats.
William Eddington, 1254, and then
and all of these cushions here.
Bishop Godfrey.
Wow. All done in tapestry for all these seats here. It's the history of the church. How'd you like to draw that needlework, folks? That's Florence Nightingale. All that work. On rows upon rows. 08, folks. The man with his head and the foliage coming from it.
Carvings. Very
interesting. We got all these circular patterns, and then all of a sudden they come to this one, and it's the Star of David.
Doves on that little seat.
Yeah.
And still appear to be standing at prayer, which was most important.
Because it slops, it folds down.
It folds down as a seat, you see.
Uh-huh.
But when they push it back, and they spend hours and hours and hours in prayer, then they were able still to give the impression of the
pelican and all these. And the pelican resembles what?
Bishop. She's in.
Okay, now. And you get down here, and it kind of shows you right about in through here, the crucifixion. And it depicts it all, and it has the dice. There's the die when the soldiers were fighting for his clothing and such. Now...
there's Mary.
Look at those cups. Still there.
Okay, and then this was a painting. The archaeologists came in, and they checked it, and they found there was... here is the original, right there. You can just see the beginning of it. Let's see if I can original. They took that off the wall with using a silkscreen method of some sort. And under it, they found this one. This goes back how far, do they think? 1150.
It's plaster, wet plaster, with paint onto West plaster for the present of it.
That is absolutely.
After college.
Yeah. Okay. The one we saw was Winchester College, and that's the signpost, and that's the street. We're going down. Fuchsia trees, if you can believe this, they're actually in Portsmouth. 45 minutes away from Winchester. And look at this lovely. Remember what she's called?
Is that the Mary Rose?
Yeah, it might be the Mary Rose. I'm
see
guessing.
The thing on the front?
The thing on the front. Let's see if I can see the thing on the front.
Can you zoom in on it?
Yeah, I am.
An old fisherman, is that?
Oh, let's see. Look at those little boats. Among all the others.
Those over there, those gray ones are the...
I can't get to it yet. Look at that one.
See the flag
is that
on
way
top?
Over on the other side?
The yes, it is.
How
that's the mast of the ship.
How can we have a cement pillar thing?
Well, I think it's the other side of it. Unless they got all that rigging just to look for it.
Big white boat. That's the Brittany ferry. That's the ferry that's got to go over to France.
Hey, Ma. Read.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Would you like to go to France on that? What the size of that? I wonder if that's the size that capsized. Couldn't find the right buttons, folks. They won't let us on it yet. Still not open to the public. Not yet. But we're in the naval yard now. And there is a lot to see. I think we're going to go over and see some.
It burst like the bomb in the winter, didn't it?
What happened?
It burst in the middle of the winter of 1890.
It burst? Why?
It didn't say. It was burst like a bomb into the mid-Victorian winter of 1860. And every battleship that was built before was now condemned to extinction, and the lesson was in shipbuilding. Okay,
for me. Too, it was built quick. You have to make it quick because it started off with a small French ship,
mm-hmm.
and they laid plates of sheets of iron over the side, and all the British shells bounced off them. So the admirals got a bit worried about this.
Mm-hmm.
So they originally designed the Warrior,
mm-hmm.
and it was sort of the secret project of the time.
Mm-hmm.
Because she could go into any battle, and she didn't even have to fire her guns, she would survive. And then when she did fire her guns, she could sing anything. So it was like a deep.
It's believed that there was only one Tudor arrow in existence until the raising of now taken the hit, and the large iron and bronze cannon would have been run out through the telescope port, usually down the side of the ship. In the stern of the ship, on this deck level, would have been the officers' quarters, and they would have had their cabins at the stern end of the ship, which contained fingerprints from more than 400 years ago. Now the next sign to the left of there is a window.
This is the timbers that are still to be put onto the Mary Rose. There's more things in the museum to see, the cannon, and I'm really not sure, you know, what else they've got in the museum. Nothing else?
Take a look on your left. Look at the scenery.
Okay, Mo says, look at the scenery. How far, Mo? Wow. We can't get over there, though.
You should see how deep the water is, too.
Wow. Dock. You mean for our ships, Mo?
Yeah, like you bring in water.
Uh-huh.
And then,
then what? Tell me. I didn't get over there. This is off the HMS Hybrina. An 18... Portsmouth. Going on the road back to Crowthorne. Just wanted you to kind of see that Jeep.
Now that I've lost everything to you.
Small,
you say you want to start
village.
Something new. And it's breaking my heart, you're leaving. Yeah. Maybe I'm grieving. But if you want to leave, take
me. Rumor has it that Bracknell is a rough town. It's an overflow of London. What, Bill?
This is crazy.
Bikers have the right of way. And look how close everybody walks.
You want me out that spot, right?
Here's where we get the Chinese food. I had to help Bill through that roundabout because it's a real bugger. And we do now of our hotel. And we're down to the first door after that. Lovely pictures all over the place. We're on the ground. We've been driving Volkswagen Golf Lobby. I've just come back from church. I was waiting to see if Ken is going to be here now. Okay, but I've got to know your names because I don't think we've ever been introduced.
Darren.
Darren? And you live in Bracknell?
Yeah. Well, that was in Crowley. I usually
smash. Okay.
So I'll do it so you don't get nervous.
No, I'm okay.
What's your name?
My name.
Sure.
Esther.
Esther. Yeah. Esther, where do you live?
I live over the road there, the staff
club. Good morning.
Hey.
Good afternoon. Yes, it is already. Oh, so you're here for the day. We just got back from church.
Oh, hey, good, good.
Yes.
We tried to catch you Friday,
this
but you were
Ken
gone.
Ken and Diane and Jessica.
We got a package of coupons and it had a Windsor there.
Hi, kiddo.
That's we so came back.
Hi, kiddo.
And then yesterday.
Going to smile? No, not today, huh?
Winchester?
Yeah.
To the cathedral.
I hope your camera's insured, madam.
Yes, it is. It surely is. My dad owns a neighborhood bar back home.
Uh-huh.
So pubs are, I kind of grew up in them. This sounds terrible. Morning, folks. So I think one of those rooms, or both of those rooms are ours. And this is where we've eaten.
Can I walk in my sleep last night?
Friends of Peter's. I could call you Friends of Peter's.
That's all right.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah. That is Chris playing with Anya.
Okay, wait a minute. Let me find Chris.
Yes. Hello, Chris.
Hi, Chris. Hey, Chris.
Oh, what? You're joking.
No.
Hang on. Can't be camera eat your heart out. No way. This no publicity. Is no publicity. Sorry.
What's your proper name?
Put him down, you don't know where he's been.
And what is your name?
I'm Peter.
Another Peter? Two Peters?
Two Peters.
Oh, we can't handle this. Two Peters.
You can handle two Peters.
Can handle two Peters.
Right.
Right, now you can take your finger right off of that. You don't have to worry about it. If you want to go to television.
Is that a recording?
Yeah.
Yes, the green light's on, it's recording.
There we go. How you doing?
Is it easy?
Bloody round.
Is there a tape in here?
There's
listen, Palance.
Oh dear.
I've got to press this red button again.
Would you please?
No, what it is that's an awful lot of money. But my brother and I, we're $50. That'd be about $6.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Then you go drink three in the first quarter of the football game.
Straight to it. Oh. Well, what? You want some more?
That would be a lot of money.
Okay, we're going to see a local cricket match. This ought to be a lot of fun. They say some of these games can last. Three days. Some more folks here. Now we've got the field, and I guess if we say baseball, it looks like baseball. They think we're crazy. Okay. These are from some of the guys we met at the local pub. Let's see if I can't get it on telephoto here. Judy, come on. I guess it is already. Okay. You can only push the button so hard. This gal gave us a ride, Madison Street. She works at the Waterloo Hotel.
It's a very solid ball.
And he's going to bowl that ball. And he's going to bring it down. And there's one of the, do we call them batters?
Now, Peter is now going out onto the outfield to have his run up to bowl. He will bowl at the batsman. They're batsmen, not batters.
They're batsmen.
Behind the wicket of the facing batsman is a wicket keeper, who is the guy with the big gloves on.
Okay, I see him.
He's like your wicket keeper in rounders or whatever.
All right.
Backstop.
Come down that runway. There he goes.
Oh, not a good bowl. That was too short, you see. You had plenty of room to hit that. And it's nearly gone for four, not quite.
Into the car. There is our house. But I don't want to pan the street too much because the sun's in the wrong position. But what I'll do is I'll show you what our neighbor's house is. We pulled into the driveway and they all came out to greet us. It was absolutely fantastic. This guy's name is Peter, I believe. Got a sense of humor like crazy, this guy. Yeah. It is Peter, isn't it?
No, Paul.
Well, I know it was one of the saints.
I'm the one that you paid. No, I'm not. I was the one that you paid to play the other one.
There. You know, my nephew did the same thing. Is it Mary? What is your name?
Kiri.
Hello. Oh, no. Come on. You've got to stand out here so I can introduce you to my mother-in-law. I'm going to send this home so that my mother and father can see this.
Look who's coming in the driveway over here.
No.
You've got visitors.
Let's see. We were just going to go to see them. Look at this. You walked all the way up?
Well, it doesn't take
that long. Oh, I see.
Hi.
Look at that. We've just come out. Here's the one corner. But that's not the main. We're in the back part of the house. Now we're coming out. I'm just worried about the sun and what it's going to do to my camera here. But anyway, here's looking at neighbor's house over this way, and here's our backyard, and they have a gardener who comes in and maintains it for the gentleman who owns that. This is what our backyard is looking like here, and that's our dining room window. This is, I'm going to climb. There we go.
Now you can see our living room, what they call the sitting room, in the back part of the house. Okay. Look at these trees. I mean, God, I feel like I'm up to Nick's Lake, folks. Now, there is a walkway here with a path down alongside. Takes me right out to the front of the house and the driveway. And this is all maintained here. Look at this. Isn't this lovely? Look at this. Ken and Diane came over to welcome us in. They brought us some Asti Spumante. Ooh, I think I stepped on a pine cone. And there's Jessica
with the chocolate face.
And wait until you see some of these birds. That's our next neighbor over there. Bill's going to go in through the... That's Bill, not a bird. Bill's going to go into the... And that's the shed where they've stored everything. And then that door there leads into the garage. And those are the bathroom, downstairs bathroom, and the kitchen windows. That's our upstairs two bathrooms and Maureen's bedrooms off the front. People on this side, Paul, have a lovely Siamese. This is Tuesday morning. This is going to be a better shot. There we go. Get away from the glare from the car. This is what the street side of our car looks like. This is on a circle. It's on a corner and kind of like a dead end. The main road's out to my right. Kids are going to pick Maureen up this morning to go to school. It's 8:15 right now. And let's see if I can walk a little bit here. Bill's already gone to work. He walked up to Ken's. And there's Maureen. You can get a nice shot. There's the side that goes to our backyard right there. Neighbors are great. Boys are supposed to pick Mo up this morning. Hey, Mo.
Yeah.
What are the guys' names? Come on out here. I can't
see.
Hugh. All right. What are their names? Hugh.
Hugh, Matt, Angus.
One starts with a C.
There's a whole bunch.
Oh, all right. And you met all the girls and you're on your way to school this morning.
Yep.
Super. Okay, maybe we can get their pictures when they come in. First day. Oops, but I'm having a hard time seeing them. Esther thinks it's a robin. Let's see if I can't get around to see him a little bit. I can't even see him with this viewfinder. Got a bird, and you can just see the orange on him. Just done a load of laundry, and it takes an hour. And I spotted... Is he still there? I can't even see him through my view. That Esther had mentioned. Maureen and Esther have gone to swim at the pigeon. Sounds like a turkey going through the trees. And we're taking it right from our kitchen window. Nice and early this morning. Maureen's going to go with Esther up to Redding. And I don't know if you're there. We go up on Maureen. Actually doing the dishes. I don't believe it. We caught her. Hey, that's pretty good, huh? This is our kitchen. I think this is the first shot we've ever had. And it goes smack into our dining room. And around out into our main hall by our main door. Here's our kitchen door, and it goes around, if we move this door here, around into our dining room. This is our hall. That goes to our garage where we have our washer dryer. We have another bath in here, a downstairs bathroom. And then the upstairs, and right up over my head, we have two bathrooms. There's a single room there, a double room there. Our room is over to the right. Maureen's room is behind me to the left. This is our hallway. A lot of glass windows. And the phone that rings so strangely. This is our sitting room right here. And this is the living room with the doors out into the back garden, and another little tiny alcove out this way. Oh, this is just absolutely lovely. Met the people in the back.
Oh, me, that's a magpie. I don't know. To check that out.
This through the curtain, but I'm scared if I move the curtain, you're not going to see it. All kind of titmice. Blues and golds, and I'm really not sure. I'm going to take a chance, and I'm going to try just opening the curtain here and see what happens. They seem a little, boy, if I gotta reach to find that curtain. Let's see here, if I can just do that. There, how is that doing? Oh, that's, whoops, much better. I see what was happening now. It was focusing in on the curtain and not what was beyond. That's why I wasn't getting a good reading. They're having a grand time. Look at these guys. They're really pretty. Let's see here. And then you can see the feeder. Oh, you can't see it from here. Yard. Bird is where we're heading. We're heading for, whoa, July picnic. Big celebration. Whose house is it at, Bill?
Duncan.
What's Duncan's last name? I never get it right.
Yeah. Donuts.
I got a couple diapers
in Tyford. This is where we are having our, going to have our party. See the red, white, and blue? This is what his neighborhood looks like. There's the corner of the road we came up. We've just come up from Bracknell. And this is his road here. There we go. Oh, Duncan?
Oh, you haven't got a video camera.
Why? Surely. No, Duncan's house. This is Bill's big boss. They've been to the States. We came out through that path. Here's the back garden here. That goes in. There's the living room. It goes clear to the front of the house. They've got a good sized house here. And these are the folks. This is their back garden. And then there's Mo. Boy, it's going to be fun trying to remember names today. Mo says she's going to get a son to you. Sure who these guys are, yeah. Don't know who he is yet. I think they know they're being photoed here. They're picking on us. Duncan says we've got to have two or three beers. Okay, and the women are in the kitchen, so I'll go catch them. Comes Diane with Jessica. Hi, Jess. And then this is the oldest son, I'm pretty sure.
Do you have a little? Lemonade, can you have a little? Oh, lemonade, that'd be great. Across the middle. So the stairs.
Actually, I like the lemonade.
Okay. She likes it.
Yes, that's not. Speak. Hello. Nothing. Come to tell me something. Oh, I don't know.
Sure, Nadine, can you introduce your sons?
This is Andrew.
Hello, Andrew.
And this is Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hey, I want you to take the
see, they're going to see you in the States.
We're going outside.
Christine.
Mom.
There we go. Cheers, Peter.
Cheers.
Nice seeing you guys again. We've seen the apostles recently, too. Simon, Peter, and St. Christopher. Yes, we did the pub crawl. Quite a crew. There's Anya, and there's... dear, I think it's... Americans and the Brits celebrating the 4th. Got all these guys cooking some really good things to eat here. Duncan in his reds.
Everybody starting to eat.
Please need a paper plate.
Paper plate. Okay, we'll do.
Please. I slice differently now.
Excuse me?
Mm-hmm. That's all right. Ignore me there. What is your name, sir?
I'm John.
Hi, John. I'm Judy DeMars.
How do you do?
Glad to meet you. You work with the rest of these guys,
yes,
huh?
Yes, I work with Duncan.
Oh, dear. Do you work with Bill at all?
Not a lot, yes.
Not a lot. Okay. Her name?
That's June.
Hi, June.
This is Judy.
Are your kids here? Is that your daughter
yes,
there?
Yes, Rosamund with red hair.
All right.
And William with the gray striped shirt.
Uh-huh, William
Rosamund.
We've met.
And
I have a William also.
Oh, yes? What are you doing with him then?
Oh, my son is 22. He's in Marblehead. He's in Connecticut.
You
he didn't
him
come
home.
Over. Yes.
What's he doing? Marblehead.
These were handmade. made for us. These are the hot dogs. Isn't that super great? These guys have been super. This is Harry. There's the gentleman that got them
Hiya.
For us. Hiya. What is your name?
It's not even lunchtime.
Where you should.
I know. I'm such a fucking. You got the time.
Oh no.
Oh yeah.
You'll ignore me after a while. I see Ken Perdone. I'll cue in on Penn there. Ken. Hey, Mr. Perdone.
Ken. Hey,
Ken.
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 Hi, Ken.
You're on camera.
Yes.
I think you played really well, but the question is why. He doesn't have too much longer. He's not going to be in contention for it anymore. Yeah, but all the things
you really don't get the feeling.
Turn that stupid.
Introduced me earlier, and I've forgotten what your name is.
Jude.
Oh, hi, Jude.
Now, I thought you were making movies.
Oh, looks like Becky's really tired. There's Dennis. Trying to get Becky to sleep. She's kicking her feet. She doesn't look too happy at all. Some new folks.
All right.
Dean. Kids.
Nope. I go through, then I look up that.
Isn't that cute? You guys are back to cooking again. There's a new face in the group. Right there. Well, we've got kids and frisbees and balls going all over the place here. Amazing, nobody's gotten clobbered yet. Okay, I don't know the names of all these new people here. So obviously Terry knows this new person here. Yeah, I think she's gotten her gift.
Not fair, Judy. I'll get mine out and do the same thing to you.
That's okay. I need a name. We haven't. I don't know your name.
Judy.
Trudy?
Judy.
Another Judy?
Another Judy.
Two Judys.
We're in trouble. Who's this good-looking guy?
That's her husband.
That's your husband, huh? Jude, that's a good, you're good at picking him. What is your name? He's going to be quiet. I don't believe this.
Well, no, I don't know whether, no, keep that a secret.
Keep that a secret?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You actually get an awful lot of money for the film.
Who's this young lady over here? Oh, I heard you did a bus tour to London.
Mm-hmm.
On a double-decker?
Mm-hmm.
Did you enjoy it?
Did it have an open top?
Yeah.
What did you get to see?
Everything.
What's everything?
Are you ever going to come see Buckingham Palace? Again, are you?
Yeah, the Tower of London. We went over the bridge.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Oh, is the sun in your eyes? How about if I stand there? Is that a little bit better? Okay. Are you having a good time?
Mm-hmm.
Good. You're not tired or anything?
No.
Good. Super. I can't see everybody. Everybody's not waving here.
She lost control. And actually, her momentum took her too
slow. That is like when you met her.
Before she realized she wasn't
there. The American thing was there would be Frankfurter,
she stood there looking out, and there was nothing. There was nothing in the
handful.
That would be your main meal.
She sat there.
And I don't know if you can get Frankfurter.
She was so proud of herself.
Hey, Ann. I don't have any names. I don't know these folks.
Rebecca.
Hi, Rebecca.
And Rachel.
Hi, Rachel.
And their mother.
What's mom's name?
Joyce.
Hi, Joyce. How old are you girls?
I'm 15.
Oh, you're lovely. Lovely ladies.
After you find out.
I'm getting red now.
Yeah, she's what? What?
She's going red.
Blushing looks very good on camera. Looks very nice.
Lucky enough, she troll and then
she's
like, oh,
that's where I had a bag.
When you say that?
Huh?
Hey, I saw your daughter.
Oh, you're filming.
No, yeah, that's okay. Saw your daughter. No, come on,
yeah,
close.
I'm staying right here.
Yeah, I saw your daughter swinging.
Yep, she's
all
doing good.
All by herself.
Yep.
That's super. You having a good time?
It's been a super time.
Super time. Good. Anything to say to the folks of the state?
No. Do you have any organized fireworks, or is it all impromptu?
There are lots of organized. The number of private parties, seems to be reducing each year. They're going more as the safety side of it.
Are you enjoying it?
Yes, you can go out. Any old shop will have them when you can buy them.
Yeah.
No different at all.
But there's more and more restrictions on there. They must be in the back office. You must be over 18. They must be in a glassed cabinet for sale. More and more people are beginning to take, I'll go down to the council place and watch that on the payment. But if you want your own, you can go out and have your own.
Oh, for example, our local villages.
You might get them for you, if you're lucky, for them.
Yeah.
Because they've all out.
That's the same around our area. Utica has theirs on one night, and New Hartford will have theirs on a different night.
This is for that Guy Hawkins then?
Guy Hawks. The Hawks? Fox. F-A-L-K-S?
F-A-U-K.
F-A-W.
F-A-W.
Sorry.
You're all right, Duncan. Go.
Did you get guy who tried to burn down Parliament.
No,
I take it he was a good guy. I'm trying to figure this out. Now, why was he a good guy?
We're not sure, actually.
They didn't actually.
We're occasionally thinking he might have been a good
guy. I mean, what was his motive?
Royalist.
He was like somebody just trying to burn the White House.
We had a whole farm of
we said to one of the girls,
plain.
I can almost taste it, Ken.
He's got the zoom lens on it as well. It's even worse.
Hi, Becky.
He will give a bigger ball.
Well, tell your daddy. Tell your daddy. He's down there.
Oh, yeah. We got all those people.
Oh.
party going on.
Just Diane. Diane, tell her to do it again. Jessica.
They were sharing the cookie, then they were hugging each other.
What did you tell them you were doing it? Look at them.
They were out here hugging each other and they were so cute.
Hey, Jess.
Jess, where's Daddy? Where's Daddy, Jess?
Oh!
Jess, give Becky a kiss. Give Becky a kiss.
No way.
Give Steven a kiss. Give Steven a kiss.
This is Steven. Jess, can you give him a kiss? Girl, this is
Becky says, I'll give you a hug, but that's all you're going to get.
She's a real lover.
Jess.
Aw, look at that. Good
get out of here.
Great difficulty, yes.
Is it easier without shoes on?
Oh, no. Hey, look at him. Try to hang. Look at him. Hey, Duncan. The ball's
coming out.
It's got to be a heavy person, Duncan.
Sorry? Two against me? I have a chance. You're tough enough.
Which one do you use? And it's going to be the first phone call.
I can get you sitting in your chair.
Thank you.
Back. Okay. Zoom back. That's it. I'm zooming.
No, no, stay there.
Stay right where you are.
Stop, stop. Go forward. Stop.
Where are we on our way to? Where are we going today?
See your fingers out.
No, no, be nice. Where are we going? Tell them where we're going.
Today, we are going to Stratfield.
Say.
On say. Stratfield, say. Say.
How long do you think it's going to take? How long do you think it's going to take to get there?
Math, that's Becky.
An hour? You think it's going to take an hour to get there?
Three quarters of an hour, something.
Something like that?
Math, do your funny smile.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Is it?
Yeah, and I'm going to go straight out on this roundabout, right?
Straight over the other side.
Okay, folks, this is a roundabout, and we're going to get squeezed between some trucks here. This ought to be exciting. I hope they stay on their own side. A lot of traffic. We're heading towards Reading because we want to go south of Reading.
There's a turbo car.
All right. I'm going to come right out this way. I don't know what that diamond means, but I'm looking for Reading. So, okay. Well, we didn't take you all the way around the roundabout because we'd probably get dizzy.
But there's a green light inside. It's a green light.
It's filming now.
Yes, it is now. I'm doing 70 miles an hour. Watch this person pass me. This person's going to go right by me, and I'm holding it at 70. If you guys can handle this.
There we go.
Here comes another one.
This is a small British standard car cruising at 90 miles an hour. Bernard's doing about 100 miles an hour. That was an English one.
Look at all the sheep. Aren't they pretty?
Got green lights on.
Yes. And it is filming, definitely. This is exciting, folks. I'm still holding it at 70. We haven't had any really fast ones come along, though.
That car's doing about 100 miles an hour.
No, not quite, not quite.
How fast, Jeff? It looks funny for me to go faster.
80.
80.
Okay, why don't you turn it off?
Hang on, hang on, hang on. This over here is a British
check it out, Porker.
Hey, we've got a turnoff coming up here.
Porker, where's the policeman? Behind you, coming up. Hey, there's a policeman, I've got him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but where are we going here?
That is a bomb disposal.
Yeah, but we're not turning off here, though, 833, right?
Yeah, that's it.
That is it?
Yeah.
It's going to be a recording. We're at the Stratford Say House. Stratfield Say, excuse me. Who lives here? Guardsmen?
This is servants' quarters.
Servants' quarters.
Okay. Actually, it might be the Duke of Wellington's house because this is Wellington Country Park.
Okay, no. If you telephoto that up, move your finger up.
How's that?
Move your finger up, up, right there.
There.
Okay, now you see it? See it zooming in? I'll try to slow it down here for you. Can you zoom right up?
Right up.
Yeah?
Pretty good?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's turn it off. Let's click it right, telephoto it. I don't know, we're not used to guys smoking here. What's this? Hi, and who are you? You spell your name very strangely.
H-U-W. Just means I'm really cool in English.
It just means what?
I'm really cool.
Oh, it means you're really cool?
Yeah. Coolest guy in Bracknell.
How old are you, Hugh?
16.
Going on 20. Going on 40.
Yeah. Zoom in on the earring.
Go zoom in on the earring?
Yeah.
Yeah. Bam, 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 Mr. Wally.
Yeah. Woo, wait a minute, I'm walking too fast here. I'm jiggling the whole camera.
This is a typical romantic affair.
Photo on. Yeah, Huey.
Hey, Hugh. Mo. Hugh.
Say cheese.
No.
Yeah.
This is a sewage pipe.
How does it smell? Telephoto went on him. Okay. Now you can pan it. Don't stay right on the monument. Pan the whole. Get the whole house. Okay. Duke of Wellington. Now turn it off to your right. Matthew is running the camera, folks. So he's playing with his new toys. We're going to go into the house shortly. We came in down that long drive.
It's not on. It is. It's flashing.
Show some leg.
English humour. Okay, cool. Ooh, very close. Yes, I have smoked a cigarette before.
Turn it off.
Show some leg. See some leg. Wait.
Go away.
See some leg.
Filming? Yep.
You're on film, Huey. Do something.
Matthew.
Inside a genuine.
Blinking. Are you on?
Yeah.
I'm always going to turn it on. Can you see through the viewfinder at all?
Yeah, it's on now. I got green light on.
Okay. A country road, and pray nobody comes along, folks. You'll be lucky. Danes Hill School. I wonder if we can see it from here. Oh, it's a little tiny school building. Well, this is a true country road. We're looking for a country pub to get a plowman's lunch. Hope nobody comes along. You gonna turn it off?
No, it's on. It's on, is it?
Yeah.
This is not a driveway, folks. This is a road, and you pray nobody's coming around that corner. Whoa. On our way back home, and I'm doing 75, folks. Believe it or not, we've got an end of something coming up here. Wokingham, Bracknell. Southern Industrial Area, right, Hugh?
Right, go right.
Oh, here? See this right here? Right there. Aha! And Bill goes in this door right where this guy's sitting. Big time. Okay, parking lot. You could turn it off. I think there's a couple buildings here in the complex. I know he's in building one. Get the sign.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
This is our school.
This is where you guys went to school?
Yep.
Go to school.
Whoa, can you telephoto that in and then?
Yeah, I am.
Right.
All right, and then turn it off. Go down, and then you can turn it off.
14, 15, physical education.
But they're all dressed up for physical.
Cricket.
How come?
They're playing cricket.
Oh,
well,
very.
They've just finished playing.
It's a very civilized game, cricket.
Otherwise, they've just got a lesson of when they're Sunday. Go to mention that. This mansion here is what might be called a big house, but it was Henry VIII's hunting house, not his mansion.
His old hunting lodge, right?
Yeah. Catherine of Aragon, one of his seven wives, she lived here after he split up before she was beheaded. This has been rebuilt since, and it burnt down, and it is haunted.
It is haunted.
Yeah.
Which way do you want? What have we got down at the bottom?
This is a typical French car. Driven by Mr. Food, who is a complete.
Look at the new housing going up. Amazing. Double decker bus. New housing. And another roundabout. Where do you want
left.
Me to go? All routes. I have to go left. This house. Right there on the corner on this end. Who lives here?
Me.
Matt? Looks like no one's there.
We are now just about to hit a curb because there's a lot of driving.
God, we're going backwards.
Here we are on a Toby hunt.
Say this is my house here. Enter my pleasure dome. Toby, come here. Come here. Come on. Sit down. Sit down. Look. Look. Look, the television. Come here.
Come here.
Look, you're on telly. Look. What's that? What's Matthew doing? Go get him. Go get Matthew. Go get him. Go. Go get him. Go see. He's gone. Zoom into his legs.
I'll go down low.
Look, go back and film him as he walks around.
He just knocked me a little toad.
This dog is dopey. Go in. What's that? What's this? Hey, look. Toby. What's that? Can you play with him, yeah? Can you come in? Can you get us playing with him? Get a dog, get a dog. Come here. Yeah. Go back, go there. Go back, go see. Who's that?
Hey. Hello. Come on to my house. Come on.
Matthew Gibbon and Hugh Kiff presenting sick, dirty, British toilet humour. Laugh with the lads.
Nah.
Thank you.
Cambridge today. We've come up with Ken and Diane. They had to deliver a machine. The gentleman we've met, we just walked over that footbridge over there. And I don't know which body of water this is. It's great. Everybody's on their lunch hour. It's 20 minutes to 1 right now. Kids are out. Actually, look at the length of that pole that he has. Came with all his gear. Grounds are beautiful, absolutely spectacular. This is the old pub. And the gentleman we were with has rented a boat. And Diane, and little one between. Diane feeding her face again.
As usual.
Ken, do you want to Ken, this is my film.
Okay.
And Bill is never...
Oh, that's Kane, yeah.
Kane, Tom?
This is actually known as the Backs, this piece.
That's where we ate our lunch?
Basically, because it goes down the backs of the colleges.
How long have the colleges been here, Tony?
Well, the earliest, I think, is about 1300 and something or other, which is Peterhouse. And they go up to about the 1870s or 80s with something like Newnham, which is there's even more modern ones than that, in actual fact. The latest one is Robinson, which was only built about 3 years ago. It was bought by a local millionaire.
So the tech industry's been
good.
I thought
I saw some ducks there.
No, he actually made his fortune on television. So he's actually the previous era of tech
millionaires.
When do we get to the back of the colleges?
Okay.
Are you?
Is that yeah? Oh yeah, that's when I got out of service.
Looks like a, no, I was going to say a bridge, but that, yes, a bridge. Okay. Is where, on our left?
It's actually on our right already. It's called Castle. It actually straddles the road.
Okay, and we'll do the whole thing.
It's quite a nice sport you can play in the summer. Though.
Yes, I've got them.
That's waiting by
good,
the bridges.
Super.
And people
wet like you are.
We're going under, folks. It's even pretty underneath. Oh, this is nice, though.
Isn't this nice?
Hey, Jess, you like that water, huh? Tony's doing a good job.
Hey, well, I don't know if you noticed, ladies, but Tony's being a nice guy. They had women out in front of the other ones paddling there, so...
Hey, Cambridge, this is great. You're getting a good shot of them, huh?
Oh, hey, this is great. Yeah, going through the bridge.
Oh, yes. We have a gentleman rower up here. What a fun thing to do for lunch.
I know it, isn't it nice?
Yes. Yeah. This must be college, too.
Visiting. Who's it, Tillians?
Oh, that's
this
fun.
This is neat, isn't it?
Yes.
I love this.
I do too.
Tony, this is the only way to work.
Any idea what these are for? Is that for mooring up or?
I think it's just holding the wall together.
Holding the wall? Yeah, you know, that's your probably absolutely.
Venice, you mean?
Yeah. Is it an extra base? Okay, we've got another bridge and another thing coming up, so let me grab it for you, Ken.
Judy said, let her have it, she'll get a picture.
Model on the bridge.
We're going to have to sit there like the water this year. Unfortunately, we're not going to have a chance.
I almost knocked Tony right off just by wiggling.
Building to,
yeah.
Is the Red Library.
that
which
is
built by, designed by the Bin that we did a lot of London ice and balls, so places like that. Yeah, right, but it's not. It's actually at the top of the iron bits. The trick being that it's actually a library, and they wanted a lot of light in it. But if you have direct light on books, it tends to destroy them, and also it's distracted. So they built the windows miles up in the building, so you get all the diffuse light, uh-huh. And shifted the floor down. And it's just an architectural trick.
Oh, it does.
Judy, spectacular.
Can you get that? Pull up the both sides of the bank there and play that card.
Oh, I can't see it in here, but I'm going to focus in on that. Look at that. That is super great. It's amazing what you can't see through this. What you can't see through here. Hey, folks, this is the life. I mean, this is super great.
I kind of like knowing what the poor people are doing.
Oh, I know it. This is great. These folks have it down pat. When they do lunch, they do lunch.
Right.
I mean, geez.
What's the duck say?
Like a big girl, huh?
Oh, you see those ducks?
Oh, I hear the duck. We must have gone right by him. There we go.
Get the boat going a different way. Now, Tony's doing all the pushing here. He's been doing a great job.
Oh dear. Get her in quickly and hold her hands in. Keep her hands in. Good. Good. We're going to do it.
Okay.
Nice job, gentlemen. Nice job.
Good job.
Well, when I was here, the rooms I used to have were on the top floor.
This is
right here.
This is where Tony went to school. Now we're going to tell Duncan that we actually
worked.
Had a lot of work setting up and all that.
Oh boy, what a day! Worked so hard. Tony did. Push it. Oops. Here we come. We're going to go under a bridge. Got to keep your hands in. Here comes the boat.
A lot of traffic today.
There's another one.
That's what Tony's doing for
us. Good job. Women drivers. Good women drivers. Getting a lot of action behind.
Got
just look at the dogs.
Three
right there.
Bridges.
The dog.
There.
Congo.
This is a weekday, folks, if you can believe this. To me, it would seem like it would be a Sunday, but
it's Friday, huh?
Yeah.
It's over here without the scaffolding.
That's King's College Chapel.
Okay.
Which is pretty spectacular from the inside.
We're still in the skiff. And I call it
the skiff. We were filming. Best time to see everyone, Cocker.
A lot of action today, a lot of action.
We're rolling here.
It's okay, the syringe is up here.
Okay.
Sit down here. Actually, a lot of fun. We've run into a jam, and he's helping them out by actually straightening them out.
That way. You're going that way.
Would you want to come back and
finish this down? Come back in about
10 minutes
then.
We can manage, okay? It's just me who can't.
Just you who can't.
I love top of
it. And last year, there's
a little
so you might like it.
That's the chapel. That is the chapel.
Also, there's some crazy plans.
We've had another collision here. We've gotten pushed over to the side, over to the edge here. Newton's Bridge. Apparently put together mathematically without bolts. And then some college students one night dismantled it and couldn't get back together, and they had to put it together with bolts. Interesting history. Interesting. Let's see if I can zoom in some more. This almost looks like the end up here, is it, Tony?
Yes, it is.
You don't need it?
He's made it to the end.
Boy.
1, 2, 3. One. That's a lot of hauling.
I guess. Wow.
You say it's going to be easier on the way down?
Now, look who we have up here doing this. Watch this technique. Oh, he's good.
Yeah, people back home, I think we've been to Venice.
Oh, I know. What, doesn't this look romantic?
Yeah, all of my parents said, oh, boy, they made it to Italy.
Hey, yeah. That's what we did. We made it to Italy.
I've got the backlight on. I hope you guys can see a difference. I don't know. I can hear, but I don't know if this will help me.
Come on, direct right.
Direct. Okay, you're direct right. Whoa. There.
Yeah, I think I can see where it is though, going downhill now, Tony.
Yeah.
Oh dear, got him soaked. They're the French.
No, I was going to say, with the language, it sounds a little bit like, oh, we're going to a little too far.
I think we've been a little bit too far then.
Playing cards there, Ken. That's funny.
Playing croquet.
Playing what, Tony?
Croquet. A traditional thing to do on the,
on the greens, yeah. Yep. Tony, this was a good idea. This is super. Which pants, babe?
Oh, they're very nice.
Yes. Give me that, Ken, Diane.
You're
right. Direct right, right behind you.
Right behind you.
Up by the crane.
Okay.
Watch your arm.
There, that's what Mo wants. Look at. Oh, smile, you're on camera. This is going to the States for everybody to see. All the girls.
There's a canoe.
A canoe or a canoe? He's gotten pretty good here. Been under the trees and under the bridges. To my right? Once again, Mo says, check them out, Mom, check them out. Sorry, guys, you're going to have to suffer. Got to have their beer. They're bitters to John Smith.
Hey, Ken,
this one's on my film here. We've been switching films in and out here. Some of Ken's. Who's going
to
bump? We're going to bump?
We might work on the other side of
it. Hey, that was good, Ken. This has got a forked end on it.
Oh, yes. Yeah,
is there sweat running down?
Clean up here and watch everybody. Wave.
Wait, everybody.
Here.
Now, where's the dates?
Okay, the dates are actually up right up on the gutters also. Like that's 1800 on that gutter strip there. And it comes right down. This is the library. We had seen.
Thank you.
I'll pretend to do it the same. They could spend a week here. Bath, and we're on A4. We're coming into the village of Marlborough, and we spotted this lovely home being refurbished. It's really interesting. And I think what they do is, after they do that, I think they go through and they put on some wire mesh so that the birds don't eat it all and get into the hedge. Marlborough.
Purple chimneys, Dottie. This is Saturday.
We're going
July.
To Chippenham. Chippenham, A4.
Stay on A4. Yeah. Are these thatched also?
Yeah.
Wow. This is quaint. This is July what? 11th, yeah. I believe.
Yeah.
Okay. Saturday. It's cooler today than it was yesterday. Yesterday you sweat like a son of a gun. Woohoo! Through that roundabout, a little jerky, but we did okay.
Want to go this way, Donna?
Yeah,
okay. There's a wedding going on.
Yeah, we saw them with a lot of streamers, but they didn't keep their horns or anything like that. Marlboro cigarettes.
Oh, I really like this. Look at it. Look!
What am I?
It's like a flea market over there.
Yep.
Oh, I guess it is, isn't it? Like one great big enormous flea market.
Send us through the town center to get to M4. I don't believe this.
Are you sure, folks?
Didn't we see a sign?
Yes.
All right. Because I wasn't looking.
With a castle on the top.
Yep, we're on the right road. How we doing, Bill?
Well,
don't you know when I see another A4?
Now listen, guys, we could have went up on the big motorway, and we opted to do this. This is a lot of fun. We're doing good. Heading towards Bath.
Huh?
By this name.
How fast are you going, Mike? 50. Dirty windshield.
Yeah, just look at that.
Yeah, it's a really old town, folks. I can't get you to my left because I've got all tall hedges. Sorry. Okay, on our way to Bath. What time is it, honey?
1:30.
It's really chilly. I feel really chilly. And we've just come up this road here, and it said watch out for racehorses crossing. This is what the countryside is looking at. I'll kind of walk over to the fence here. Half of what, honey? Get you up here to the fence and see what we can see up here. Oh, this is pretty countryside. Horse riders coming out. Look, over here, right straight out. Look, up here.
What?
Right here. Look.
That's what we should be.
I know it. We're going to have, we really have to do this. I mean, this is what we really think Britain is like. These old homes, and I'm glad we stayed on A4 instead of went up to the motorway of M4. I'm really pleased.
That's what we didn't get there.
Did you? Well, just think, Hugh and Matt are on their way to Wales right now. We might be going to Wales next Wednesday. Don't remind her. Why, Mo, do you miss the guys?
Of course.
Of course. How old are some of these folks, Mo? Can you tell?
They're about my age.
Girls, boys, can you tell?
Yeah.
Pretty, Thistle. Really pretty. Go down here, Kippy. Right here. There's past fields of poppies. I don't know why. I haven't quite figured out. Poppies seem to be mixed in, but they were only in one section. It's really neat.
There. Some little white spots on the hill to your left. Good. Hell in your way, so you're gonna have to start taking it from now.
Uh-huh.
Something going on over here.
Is it a fair?
No, some kind.
Close to Bath. Ooh, stone walls here, guys. I wanted you to see all the farmlands, but I guess I didn't do such a good job.
Want to go back up and back down?
No, it's okay.
There's a place to turn around right here.
It's okay.
You want to walk over to the fence?
Said Bath 4 miles.
City. Probably should have. Did you get the sign, honey?
I hope I did. It was on. Doesn't mean anything. That goes way back to Roman times, Roman baths. This is where all your Victorian ladies lured. Summers. Look at some of
these. See them stacked along there.
They're stacked.
Look at them things. Are 4 3 4 stories high, Jim.
Where, honey?
Right here.
All along that side of the hill.
Whoa. Going towards the city center and going to find a car park. We are in Bath, I think.
Yes,
seems
we
to
are.
Be. Seen that car park at all anywhere?
Yeah. Okay. Saturday antique markets.
Starting last week.
Is there a pub anywhere?
Right here on the corner. Mm-hmm.
This is a car park, as like at home. I really don't know.
People fishing at the falls. Fishing with bobbers, but I can't make them out because they're off the plane. Coming up from the river. That appears to be a castle in the background. There's a clump of houses on the hillside.
Okay, man. Off we go. Eric, Never trust an American, ladies and gentlemen. I know more of the story. Just in case, I do bring my own tank of water. You're also going to see it, hopefully, with a difference. So can you just grab on that for a second? Dive in. You'll get the tart around the back. Okay, Rose. That's okay. I wouldn't mind, but I quite enjoyed it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. The idea is I get out the chains, not the apron, okay? That's okay, lovely. Okay. To make up for the fact that there's only my hands tied together, to make up for the fact that there's only a bucket of water, not a tank of water, we're going to perform this stunt today as I have never performed it before.
Properly.
Please try to contain your sense of excitement on this stage, I guess. I'm going to attempt it with my hands tied securely behind my back. Shut up. Thereby bringing the chains to the rear of my body.
Let's go
which
back
position
to
I shall make my escape. As soon as I get there. Great audience. You laugh at everything apart from the jokes. It's wonderful. Eric has tied the chains too tight. It was going to be a bit of a premiere there for you today. I will now have to move my hands in front of my body as usual. I'm sorry about that. It's going to be something. By the way, I forgot to say, I should just say that this is It's pathetic, really, isn't it? Anyway, it is how I make my living, and this will be the last stunt that I'll be performing. And after this, I'll be taking the collection. You're way ahead of me, madam. So if any of you are going to walk away without contributing, if you'd like to do so while my head's actually in the bucket, it'll save you a lot of embarrassment.